Hello, hello. We are here for another jingle. And this one is called Dance in the Rain. I made this a while ago, and I am talking to empaths today. I have a list of 5 different ways that we can dance in the rain, even while we're going through our healing. It's sometimes difficult to dance in the rain. It really is. But as we're going through our healing, it is very important that we find time to be happy, that we find time to do things that bring us joy. I spoke about this in the last 2 long forms, so go back and watch those. I have one on purpose and another one yesterday I did about finding comedy, which is something that I used to do. So the first thing that I want to talk about is going for some sort of nature adventure. Now, I know I am water, so I like being around water. If I go to a beach or if I just sit by the lake, if I'm in Babylon, my heart just regulates in such a way. So figure out what your element is and get to that element. If you like, if you're earth and you like trees and all of those things, get around that. If you are fire, I don't know what fire does, but find out what your element is and find something to do in that element, and it will bring you joy, guaranteed. Number 2 is a hobby, and I spoke about that yesterday. I used to crochet and I used to really love doing things that brought laughter. What is your hobby, or what is a hobby that you used to find joy in? Find a way of getting to do that hobby again, and that will help you to be able to dance in the rain that may be going on around you. You may have turmoil, maybe at work, and this one thing, like sitting down and crocheting for half an hour or whatever, can help bring you joy. It can help bring the ability to dance while you're going through the rain. Number 3 is journaling and meditation. I journal every single day, morning and evening. And there's some days I don't meditate as often as I do, like on a regular basis. But today I felt you need to meditate. And what happens when I meditate is I may not get the answer now, but sometime throughout the day, because I've taken that time to still myself, an answer comes to me. Journaling and meditation can really help calm a nervous system that is on fire because you were around narcissists or you've left narcissists, you're healing from a narcissist. You need to find a way to get out those emotions that are going through your mind and your body. And journaling is a really good way of doing that. If you're looking for journals, I have some in my Sambuka shop on Ko-fi. So just check the description box. I have several journals. And I have the Queen's Planner as well that's still available. So check the description box. I have some journals that will be a good asset for you to have. Number 4 is something that people may think is not something that they should be doing at this stage of the game, but I really think that it can help. And it's give back. Now, we are giving souls, and it could be that you gave too much in the first place, and that is why you're in this position. Well, when I was leaving my ex-husband, I knew that if I didn't get away from me, I would get into a real deep victim stage, and I still had challenges with that, the victim thing, but how can you small give back so that you're feeling that this part of you, which is the empathy, isn't being tossed to the curb? I'm not talking about necessarily a method that will take hours and hours, but maybe you can volunteer at a soup kitchen for 1 hour a week or something like that. And that can just give you that empathetic thing that we as empaths need to survive. Yeah? So just think about it, figure out how you can do it in a way that still brings you joy, that doesn't take away from you. And the last thing is self-care. And when you elevate as an empath, the self-care will be something that we do naturally. Before I go to bed, I have specific routines for my face, for my body, for all the different parts of me that I need to do something before I go to bed. I have a routine. When you elevate as an empath, you start realizing that you need to take care of yourself. So even today, I took a self-care day. I'm just relaxing. It is cold, so I'm bundled up in this shawl, and I'm just taking it easy. Self-care. Take a self-care day if you can, financially, or find ways of taking care of yourself, whether it be doing your eyebrows or your nails or whatever. Take a self-care day in the midst of the chaos and the healing and all the different things that you're going through, so that you can go forward in a rejuvenated state. So those were the five that I have for helping you to dance in the rain in spite of All right, so number one, nature. Number two, a hobby. Number three, journal and meditation. Number four, give back. And number five, self-care. So comment below, tell me how you take care of yourself while you are going through your journey for self-healing as an empath, as an INFJ, as a person who has come out of narcissistic relationships. I would love to hear in the comment section. So let's keep this engaged and let's keep this nice and respectful. Until tomorrow, this is Sambuka. Remember to sprinkle your delicious flavor throughout your day and be infectious to all who come your way. Just color. Bye-bye.